Hello, hello, hello. Welcome, guys. Come on in. Ah, welcome to Valentine's Day. Happy February, everyone. How's everyone doing? Who did I see? Who did I see? Oh, I see that this is not playing very nice. We're gonna stop that, and we're gonna start that, and we're gonna control it and see if it makes it a little. Oh, no. Oh, maybe. Let's try that. See what happens. Very nice. Or we just do it the old-fashioned way. Either way works. Ah, let's see. Nope, you're just in the mood to be a squanky little duck. Okay. let's see. Matthew, welcome. Hey, Anne, how's it going? Rita, hello. I love it. Louise, hello. Laugh out loud, definitely. Elaine, hello. Oops, I mean fifth. Sixth. Carla, well, I'm early for a change. Well, thank you guys for joining me. Rachel, woohoo, definitely. How is everyone's double down day going? Mary, finally made it to one. Weaver, hello. Jessica, hello. Heather, I hope everyone's day has been good so far. For anyone who is doing Publish and Thrive, I hope you enjoyed that kickoff call. It was so good. Okay, I don't know what I'm going to do with that. I'm going to have to fuss with that after. Let's see. Diane, afternoon hearties and a happy Saturday. Hope you're doing great, Diane. Heather, my candle is lit and I'm making myself cocoa to drink. Perfect. My candle is open. and my entire room now smells like basically pina colada with a little bit of kicky of oceany kind of smells. I'm being transported. Phyllis, hello. Mary Jo, how's it going? Yes, the candle, definitely. The candle is lit. I have some popcorn and a full water bottle. Awesome. Very good, guys. Very good. My day is great. First Sarah, now Tracy. I love it. Hey, Rosin, how's it going? Tyler, welcome. Well, I'm so glad you guys could all make it. Hey, Juanita. Excellent, excellent group. Phyllis, working on getting some reading done today, also on some personal projects. I would like to get some free writing in today. Perfect. Stephanie, I've added 2 chapters, working on the 3rd one. I'm only here for the first 2 sprints. Then I get to jump into my D&D group. Whew, sweet. First game of the year. Nice. I hope you have an amazing time. My daughter and I keep talking about we haven't done it yet, but we keep talking about it. Sam, just starting on my double down day. Level. My brain had other stuff it wanted to do today. And that's okay. We still have lots of time left. Diane, I am grateful. Grateful to be here, Tracy. Thank you, Tracy. Oh, you're so welcome, Diane. You were always so sweet. Jessica, the ice is still on our driveway and front porch. Be careful. Be careful, guys. Winter's not over. We want it gone, but it's not over. Happy double down day, Elaine. Perfect. Carla, need to get my flash fiction prompt for today done. I wrote a couple already, but don't like either of them. Write another one. Then combine them. Maybe something interesting will come. Phyllis, candle open as well. Loving this lavender thyme scent. Lovely. Stephanie, you should do it. I just bit the bullet with a few friends at the start of the pandemic, and we're still having fun with that campaign. You won't regret it. Oh, good to hear, good to hear. Hey, Lori, welcome. Rita, happy Saturday, writing friends. Oh, okay, guys, we are going to dive in. Ice melt is not helping as well as we hope. Stubborn. Temperatures are too low to be cooperative, right? okay, guys, I gave it some thought from our last session, and I know we almost had a 50-50 split for the warm-up, the cool-down, so what we're going to do today is we're going to do a 15-minute warm-up, 2 45s, and a 10-minute cool-down. That way everybody gets what they need. We get to warm up, get the juices going, do a little bit of reading of what we did yesterday or the day before, touch base with our characters, our settings, the situation the characters are in, and sort of start just kind of getting the writing juices warmed up. Then we're gonna dive deep for 2:45s, and that way we can really stay in flow and really move our stories forward. And then we'll have a 10-minute cool down at which we can just kind of wrap up our thoughts and have a nice, neat little package by the end. Let's see. Stephanie, I'm just looking forward to being able to let my imagination just go free. Oh, love it. Lori, I had an epiphany last night with a whole new way of writing my work in progress, and I start over again. So far, it's working. I was so stalled, and I think it was because I didn't like the plot. Yeah, that's, I hear you on that. Elizabeth, I took a nap today since my pain dictated me to, Elizabeth, hugs. It's going to go away. Your life, it's going to get back on track. You just take care, do what you can when you can, and take the rest as you need it. Your body said you needed a nap, and you listened, and that is so smart. Mary, today is my first day in live sprinting. I am using this time to refocus on an old project. Wrote about 500 words in the last set of sprints, hoping to double that during this session. Beautiful. Mary, hello, doing a major push of housework, big annual inspections, moved up to Tuesday and Wednesday this week, so my double down day is doubling down on getting the house clean. Got a head start with dishes and laundry. Well, that's not very cool of them. You had until like, what, the 9th and 10th before. Deep breath, writing will happen, but do what you need to do, right? Elaine, welcome to the sprints, Mary, definitely. Diane, welcome, Steph, and away you go. Elizabeth, my dad took a walk this morning when it was negative 12 degrees. No. Just no. No. That is not a pleasant walk. That is, we have a dog. We have no choice but to go outside. And even we had wind last night, and he was like, yeah, I'm going back inside. I don't care what you people think. Lori. My warm-up will be working on a guest blog post I need to send out tonight. Sweet. Phyllis, I love it. Nice to have a short warm-up and cool down. Nice, yes. I'm hoping it really works for us. I hope it just encapsulates what we need. Jessica, did you hear me talking about you, baby? Jessica, I for sure need the warm-up. I haven't worked since Wednesday. Long story, I'll tell you during planning tomorrow. Nobody wants to hear the story today. Oh, no. Well, you're back to writing. It's okay. You're back. It's good. Rita, it sounds good. Stephanie, Diane, oh, no. I'll be here for about an hour still. I'll leave partway through the second sprint. Mary, hi. Love your heart, Stressy. Thank you. I decided the Valentine's Day needed to happen. I decided to take my smart bulb and give us a little bit of peak ambience. let's see. Louise, to Lori, I did the same thing and the story is now going so well. It's amazing. Love it. Yeah, sometimes we're stuck because we're stuck. Something's not working. Diane, I know, and away you go with all your creativity, sweetheart. My husband plays and he plays magic. Nice. Elizabeth, I did get a bunch of chapters printed for developmental line editing this morning. So now I can use a red pen to do editing. Nice. My dad said that the temperature was the reason he wanted to take the walk. Interesting. Thank you, Diane. There'll probably be more. as most of you guys probably know, I'm slightly obsessed with Valentine's Day to the point that I actually got married on it. So, you know, we kind of love it around here. Rita, I'm lucky we just opened the door and out goes the dog. Live on agriculture. Ah, yes. Nope, this one is, we live in the city, he has to be leashed and he has to be walked, and he is, I call him my California puppers because he hates the rain, He likes the snow when it's like it's fresh and he can bury his little nose in it and he gets a little lid on his nose and he loves that. But the rain and the wind, not his thing. All right, I love the idea of variety of sprint legs. Perfect. Yeah, we do all sorts of fun things around here. Elizabeth, I'd rather take a walk in 110 degrees than take a walk in control. I think I'll pass on either. Oh, let's see. Jessica, nobody probably wants to hear it tomorrow either, actually. Oh, Jessica, hugs, hon. Bella's been staying inside warm and toasty and drinking mint tea. Beautiful. Okay, guys, we better get to it. All right, so for anyone that is new, first thing you've noticed is we don't just do standard 20 and 25 minute sprints around here. We play with it and we have some fun and we see what really will allow us to deeply get into our writing and really move our manuscripts forward. The other thing that we do is my 2 minute micro sprint plan, in which we define what we're going to do each and every sprint. You figure out what you need to reveal about character, plot, or setting, what you're trying to get your protagonists to do on the page. Sometimes they fight us. Do you really need to make them do it, or is their idea even better? The obstacles and opportunities you're going to toss at them to enrich your story, explore relationships, create more conflict, delay them getting what they want or need. The action steps you're going to take to get there, so your beginning, middle, end. The resources you're going to need at hand, iPad, laptop, phone, anywhere you've taken notes, post-its, index cards, resource books. Bring those craft books out that you're using right now. Don't put them on the shelf. Don't leave them on the shelf. If you are actively doing, using the snowflake method, have that book next to you. That way, when you turn around and start going, hold on, what do I really need to do in step number 5? You can pull it out. You've got the details right there. And finally, the outcome you're looking for. Okay, guys, I need my little wee notebook. Where is she? Nope, wrong one. Did fit chance. I need to put a sticker on there or something. All right. So I always use a small little notebook and then I just write down what my basically thoughts are. That way I can go back and refer to them. And it helps me to, because sometimes you end up going off on a tangent and you do need to go back to your notes. Okay, guys, if you've already written today, you're going to use the prompt in the next sprint I will. And if these are your first words in the first sprint I will. 2 minute timer, guys, and go. Okay, let's see. What did you guys come up with? For mine, I'm going to take some quick notes. I've decided this story needs a prologue. Whether or not that prologue stays, that's a different story. But that prologue has the potential to set everything in motion and to... It does include the main characters, which I know prologues quite often do not. But in this case, I know I have shouldn't do this to myself. I have two options of how I can do that. I can go way back before them, which might be interesting. Which I think I will today try to write both versions, actually, now that I'm thinking about it, just to see which one will eventually either make it or not. Let's see. Okay, where am I ending off here? I really wish my other thing was working here. It's easier than using this one, but that's okay. My cousin was born on Valentine's Day. Cool. Matthew the Requel is going to be given away to mailing subscribers. Nice. Inca, I wrote 5K today, so I'm moving on to editing. Nice. I got some almost Valentine's as well, born before. Aw, sweet. And my mother-in-law asked me why I couldn't just keep my legs crossed for a few more. Oh, mother-in-laws. Oh, honey. Oh, wow. Yeah, no. It doesn't work that way. Let's see. I want to do that 100-minute sprint I suggest someday, and I may do it one day next week. I can let you know next weekend how it goes. I still just need the timer. I don't have the timer yet for that one. Everything else I have is going to ding in between, so I'm going to get a timer. Let's see. Let's see. Triple C, hey! Working on notes for my upcoming workshop on sensual movement. 70 pages of notes to edit. Definitely a nice bonus. Ooh, sweet. Stephanie, I usually work best in short sprints, but I'm still interested to hear. It's something we've been kind of working on. So some people are splitting it up, and that 45 is becoming 20 with a 5-minute break and another 20. Just as they kind of work into it. Or breaking up and then kind of going, okay, 10 minutes break, right? And just kind of shifting it around a little bit as they go. Let's see. It's amazing because there is, it takes a bit to get used to it, but once you do, it's nice to could really stay in the zone. Let's see. Elizabeth, in the next sprint, I will do some editing with a red pen. Nice. Heather, in the first sprint, I'm going to move the next couple of scenes over to my development edits folder so I can start working on. Nice. Stephanie, in this first sprint, I will do the corrections for the first two chapters that my alpha readers gave me. Good plan. That's perfect for that length of sprint, actually, too. Mary, in the next sprint, I will finish the dishes and take laundry out of the dryer to be sorted and put away. I hope you can get everything done, hon. I'm sure your place is probably perfect anyway, but do what you need to do. Jessica, in the first sprint, I will look over what I worked on last time to remind myself, and then after that, I work on plot points so I can hopefully start drafting soon. Nice. Phyllis, in the first sprint, I will finish some housework. I will start making dinner and update my writing Kanban board. Perfect. I always love how precise yours are. Elaine, in the next sprint, I'm going to finish up my new Facebook ads for blurb testing and then write my newsletter draft. Nice. Rachel, this first sprint, I need to take time to get supper done so I can then focus the rest of the night on revisions. Perfect. Heather, I think I scared my teenage daughter yesterday. I found my favorite baby name book and had it out. I've never done that to my daughter, but oh, I'm so shit. Rita, in the next sprint, I will write up the summary for this chapter. Brinley is alone and exploring her family's magical book that was recently found hidden in the basement. All over that. Carla, I'm focusing on who the character is for today's flash fiction prompt. Nice. Jessica, I actually sprinted with Jenna last night, but all of those sprints were self-care because I needed it. This morning when I sprinted with Angela, it was making the bed and clearing up so I could focus. That's okay. You have to do that. Matthew is 3,000 words okay for a reader magnet? Sounds great, actually. Beefy enough, easy enough, not too big for bandwidth and stuff. Sounds great. Let's see, I get to write the first kissing scene in my romance novel. Finally! I love that. Mary, I will type up handwritten scene from a notebook to get in flow and see where Orchid and Alyssa want to go after daring each other to jump on a moving train. Ooh! Oh, I love the action. Inca, there's no minimum limit. 3K is a solid short story length. It is, definitely. Yes, definitely exciting. Perfect. She's laughing. it's good, huh? You're good. Mary, I am following my outline. I am not a pantser. Last month, I pulled my current work of prose apart and put the entire book on Splatter. Loving that tool, and I'm finally at a place to rough again. Oh, yeah. Matthew, it's just that Story Origin recommends 10,000. I've heard a lot of 10, but it depends on the story, and every story has its kind of magic length. And if you have one ready, that's got it's 3K and it's good and solid. If you try to fluff that thing up to 10K, it's not going to help it anyway. Plus, if you have something now, well, then that's something you can begin with. If you can get with the 10K later, do something else, right? Let's see. Mary, I will say it's looking a lot better than when I started, but perfect. I wish. You'll get there. Jessica, if my desk is cluttered, I won't focus. I start messing with stuff on the desk. Oh, we all do. Mary to Mary, what do you love about Plotter? Easier curve than Scrivener. Yeah, I'd agree with that. Inca, it's just a recommendation. If the story is done, it's done. Definitely don't pad it to meet some arbitrary limit. Just bill it as a short story and call it good. Yeah, exactly. Stephanie Diane, if you've ever seen the laugh with the hand behind their head anime laugh, that's me. Okay, guys, let's dive in. We're going to do our 15-minute warm-up. Start getting the juices flowing, get the words on the page. I'm going to do handwritten today and stay very connected to the story and the characters. And let's get warmed up, guys. Okay, 15 minutes. Good luck, good writing, and I'll see you on the other side. Thank you. So how did you guys do? Yeah, Frodo's joining us. He's a little sad. Daddy's not here today. Sister just went out. Stuck with mom. Is that true? You stuck with mommy? Let's see, what'd you guys come up with? Yes, we have a new music mix. Some of it you will recognize from when we did our virtual writing retreat and we did Venice. Some of it's from our Paris one, and others are just some of my favorite instrumental pieces that we've used. That's probably been a while for some of them. But yeah, I'm quite loving the mix, and I hope it's not too romantic. The idea was to have just a nice little bit of energy, a little bit of something different, just to kind of get our minds kind of peaked. let's see. Stay there, Bubba. let's see. I have a chapter in my story where there's a thunder snow, and I found that thunder snow is fascinating. It's very interesting. It definitely is. Good boy. Perfect. Look at that bumper. I love it. Yeah, he's a very good boy. He's a love bug. Not very conducive to writing, but that's okay. He doesn't want to do this too often, so when he's willing, I'm like, okay, we're doing this fine. I just joined. What is this, romantic music? Yeah, that one I think was the Venice one. One of the Venice ones. Hubby found that one, so I'm not 100% sure where he got it. Phyllis, great for sprint. Update a Kanban board. Finished housework. Starting under. Nice. Looking forward to a longer sprint. Definitely. That's with me too, Phyllis. NW, 439 for me. Nice. Carla, 500 words. It's pulling together. Nice. Rita, I ended up starting with potatoes in the oven. Nothing wrong with that. Elizabeth, I did some editing with my pen after I put some cinnamon on some mini potatoes I cut in half and then put those in the oven to cook for half an hour. Cinnamon, interesting choice. I don't think I've ever done that. It'd be good though. Phyllis, 189 words. Tyler, 83. Good warm up. Phyllis to Elizabeth, sounds tasty. Yes. Sam, 426. Are you going to store? Are you going to see? Mary, puppy dishes are done and clothes are ready to put away. Mission accomplished. Perfect. Heather, I love that. Love the music. I got two scenes, chapters pulled from the rough draft, one for each 45 minutes sprint. Nice. Mary, 84 words, getting the cobwebs out of my head. That's exactly why we warm up. Let's see, Elaine, I got one ad done because of fiddling with the wording. That's easy to do, though. You want it to be good. You want it to be effective. So it's fiddling, but it's good fiddling. Mary, enjoy the music. Phyllis, yes, I thought that was music from Italy. Yeah, I knew that was from Venice way back. When did we do that? Was that the beginning of last year? I think it might have been. Elizabeth, Phyllis, I have some chicken drumsticks in the oven too, so dinner will be delicious. Beautiful. Phyllis, Lori, I am joining you soon. Just started making dinner. all we're gonna have our virtual dinner here. Say, Mary, oh, you squiggly. What? Okay, I'm sorry, my lap's not the biggest daddy's. Mary, 458 words transferred from paper to docs with some more detail added in. Getting a flow. Nice. Inca, I edited 3 pages. Looking forward to these longer sprints where I can really dig in. Yes. Me too. Definitely for Phyllis. Elizabeth, cinnamon on mini potatoes. It's delicious. My mom did that once for me when I was sick with these mini potatoes, since she read online that cinnamon could help me with what I was dealing with, and I got hooked. Cool, and it's beneficial. Even better. Triple C, enough for one day, bath time. Thank you for hosting. You are so welcome. Thank you for joining us, Triple C. Elizabeth, medicine wasn't helping me enough, so desperation kicked in at the point that, oh no. Well, I'm glad it was a solution, right? Triple C, have a good night, everyone. You too. I hope you have an amazing, relaxing bath with a good book. Okay, guys, we are going to dive in with our second. Oh, hello, you're back up? Okay. okay, sit, sit, please. Thank you. Stephanie, got my 2 chapters edited. Yes, I know. Edited with the little things that were there. Perfect. Okay, guys, we're going to dive into our second 2-minute micro sprint plan. This one is 4:45. Are you hinting you want to go down? What you need to do is figure out what you want to reveal about character clutter setting, what you're trying to get your protagonist to do on the page, the obstacles and opportunities you're going to toss at them, the action steps you're going to take to get there, the resources you're going to need at hand. If you forgot to grab something, just grab it and put it down in front of you. Try to surround yourself with everything that you need. That includes your favorite beverage, whole glass of water, maybe a snack if you haven't eaten for a bit, a little something. And then finally, the outcome you're looking for. In the next sprint, I will. 2-minute timer, guys. I just have to get back up here because it's in there. 2-minute timer. Good luck, guys. Or not good luck. I'll see you in the episode of 2 minutes and with our plan. This is 4:45, and I can't speak right now. Okay, guys, let's do our 2-minute micro sprint plan. Okay, sit down. Sit. Please. Sit. Thank you. Ooh. What do we got here? The sentiment didn't help, but something else did, so at least the solution was found. Oh, that's good. Phyllis, in the next sprint, I will finish making dinner. Let's see. Where did I leave off? Making dinner and eat it. I will also do some reading. If there is time, I will finish a shredding project. Oh, perfect. Forget, I don't often do that. Elizabeth, in the next sprint, I will continue editing the Thunder Snow chapter and get some herbal tea. Take dinner out of the oven. Perfect. Do not burn your food. Mary, hubby reminded me I promised to fix cream salmon for dinner. Boy, this next 45 minutes will partially be preparing dinner. That's okay. Elaine, that sounds yummy, Mary. Yes. Stephanie, I'm going to do some of my editing for another chapter in the same book. Basically editing and reading chapters to my alphas as I go. Nice. Elaine, in the next sprint, I will finish these ads and do the newsletter. Heather, in the next sprint, I will work on the male POV. Let's see. Jessica, in the next sprint, I will try to figure out how to fix the plot issues that I discovered Wednesday when I sprinted with Melissa than I was supposed to work on Thursday and yesterday. Don't worry about the days that didn't happen. You probably were thinking about the story at that point as well. So That's going to help you today to be more centered and focused. Mary, in the next sprint, I will take a 15-minute break to rest my back, and I will put away the laundry. After that, I will sweep and mop the kitchen floor. If there's time left in the sprint, I'll vacuum. You could do this, yeah. Carla, this sprint, I'm going to finish the first draft and maybe start the edits. Heather, POV's chapter, I need to add at the beginning to show an example why he is concerned about the female POV before he goes to her best friend with his concerns. Oh, interesting. I like that, how you've broken that down. Nicole, in the next sprint, I will finish off the scene with a kiss and then start the next chapter. Cool. Mary, if not, vacuuming will be done the following sprint. Lori, in the next sprint, I will write the meet cute, although both have known each other for years. I will try to show their attraction. They're trying to hide from one another. Oh, perfect. Let's see. Jessica, what is the pupper going to work on this sprint? Apparently falling asleep in my lab. Matthew, to any horror writers out there, Dracula may be the world's most famous vampire, but he wasn't the first person to be accused of being one. Interesting. Tell more. Sam, I'm going to eat supper and then maybe do some more writing in the next sprint. Beautiful. Dan, hi, Berto. You're a beauty. Aw, thank you. Yeah, he's a cavalier Shih Tzu cross, so he looks totally like a cavy, but then he's got little tells. He's too tall. He's too, you know, he's too big. Oh, which is funny because neither breed is big, but he's a good sized pupper. let's see, Elizabeth. Okay, I won't let a fire start in the oven. Not that I was planning on that. Perfect. Jessica, I was thinking that as well. Yes. Emery, hi, posting in chat for the first time. Happy to be joining everyone. In the next sprint, I'm going to work on mind maps by the goal, motivation, and conflict for all three main characters. Nice. Which one are you going to start with? Matthew, sorry, just watched a tutorial on story origin where the narrator called Dracula the OG map. Oh, interesting. Mary Jo, next sprint, I will be reviewing my coach's notes and creating scene cards. Oh, am I cooking you? Scene cards of the next scenes to happen. Select one and begin writing. Beautiful. Okay, guys. Deep breath. We are going to dive into a beautiful 45-minute sprint where we can pour ourselves onto the page and make real progress on our stories. Let's try to stay focused and stay on task and get the move our stories into the next scene or chapter and beyond. Okay, guys, good luck, good writing. I'll see you on the other side of 45. Thank you. So how did that one work out for you guys? I got lots of great information. I'm gonna have to go through with, I don't know, post-its or something to clarify and break things down. I should give myself a little more white space here. But fabulous notes. Definitely move things forward. Saw some very awesome information there for Origins of Vampires. Very cool, guys. Let's see, Heather. Okay, that's the fastest development I've done for me. Usually I'm doing good to do one chapter in a 45-minute sprint. I did both chapters. I set up for with 6 minutes to spare. I love hearing that. That is awesome. And if you still had time, that means that you liked what you did too, because you weren't going back and picking at it. So that is pretty awesome. Phyllis, good sprint. Finished dinner. Going to head out now. Have a nice evening. See you tomorrow. Fly with me. Yes, guys, I am back tomorrow with our planning session at 3 p.m. Eastern and our writing session at 5 p.m. So come and join us and get your week planned, and then we can dive on into our writing and get that checked off as well. Let's see. NW, 1,264 that sprint and 3,981 for that day. Woo! Very nice. Carla, running story through pro writing aid and getting some edits done. Nice. Elaine, got the ads done. Start newsletter. Beautiful. Elizabeth, I did some research on grand mal seizures for this chapter, where the mother has a grand mal seizure during a power outage during a thunderstorm. Is the daughter has seizures? No, that is worst case scenario. Wow. Tyler, I got 570 words at sprint. Elizabeth, I am eating dinner and dinner is delicious. Nice. Michelle, 488 that sprint and 3,243 for that day. Woo! Loving these numbers. Louise, spent a little too long on Facebook, but got more words added to this book. Nice. Tyler, got some research done on North Dakota and big native cats from there as well. Sweet. Embry, my mind maps results in a whole list of questions about characters to explore and pre-write about. Oh, I like that structure. Very nicely done. Kelly, working on editing the end of my first chapter. Sounds good. Rita, happy progress. Read 2 chapters and chapter summaries. I even decided to put in the location of my writer's notebook. Love setting up a new writer's notebook for my current project. Sweet. I got flagged with a slight copyright there. So one of those songs is no longer on the friendly list. Even though they all came from sources where they were supposed to be. So I'm going to have to go through, figure out which one it was, remove it from the list. And I hope that I can keep using my list. The rest of it. Let's see. Mary, putting away clothes took a little longer. Plus had to take an extra break at the end, but I got the clothes all put away and some pulled out and bagged up to donate. Oh, beautiful. Faith, first time posting in chat. Welcome. I got 730 words, which I'm very happy with. Very nicely done. Carl and Elizabeth, if you think Thundersnow is cool, check out Frost Wakes. Oh, those two words don't belong together. Mm-mm. Elizabeth, this mother hasn't had a grand mal seizure before this chapter, and she has the grand mal seizure because she has a benign brain tumor behind her left eye that she finds out about at the hospital. Rachel, I couldn't revise more than a chapter, so I switched gears to begin setting up my Ko-Fi. Nice. Elizabeth, Carla, I will check that out. Thanks. Yeah, it sounds great. Okay, guys, we're going to dive into our 32-minute microsprint plan. This is for our second 45. What you need to reveal about character plotter setting, what you're trying to get your protagonists to do on the page, the obstacles and opportunities you're going to toss at them to create conflict, reveal character, relationships, and just to really flesh out the story. That's kind of where it happens, right? The actual steps you're going to take to get there, the resources you're going to need. Speaking of resources, once I get you guys started, I'm going to run upstairs and get a water because I have not had one and I kind of need one. And finally, the outcome you're looking for. Hubby decided he wanted to talk, so I only ended up with 20 minutes, did a chapter and a half of copy edits. Well, that's pretty good. At least he let you have 20. Mary finished writing a train jump scene and outlined next few scenes. I'm a mashup of a pastor and plotter. You're pretty normal. I think a lot of people are, really. I don't think anyone is... It's very rare to find anyone who fits either in one or the other. They're all a little blend, right? Those dang hazard interruptions. Okay, guys, in the next sprint, let's put on that 2-minute timer and figure out what we're going to do with our next 45-minute sprint. What's going on? Oh, there. Thank you. Okay, what did you guys come up with? I don't know, 45 minutes, they're both somewhat short, but I kind of wrote them both down. We'll see. But I think I'm ready. I have enough notes, so I think I can write those two and then see. I have a feeling one will be the prologue and the other will serve as a flashback, I think is how I'm going to do that, because I know I kind of should have both. Let's see. Elizabeth, this mother has brain surgery to remove the tumor, so I need to make sure that gets written well. This woman gets brain surgery, and while mom is in the hospital, her daughter makes a big decision. Oh, Sam's supper took longer than expected. Phone call, in the next sprint, I will definitely get to write. Yes. Elaine, in the next sprint, I will try to write this newsletter draft, or I might go back and work on my magnet instead. Either way, I definitely need a stack. Rachel, I am going to finish setting up my Ko-Fi and the shop within it to offer my story structure tool of my serial stories. Nice. Heather, in the next sprint, I'm going to transfer the next scene chapter for developmental edits and work on editing it. If there is still time, I will start on dinner when I am finished. Nice. Mary, in the next sprint, I will take the other half of the load out of the dryer. have a compact dryer, so I have to split loads when I wash and put it away, and then I'll hopefully get it to the floors. It's actually, the compact dryer is kind of nice for that. You split the loads, but at the same time, you have a more manageable load to put away and less intimidating and overwhelming. Rachel, typo queen, strikes again. Were you going for structure? Rita, in the next sprint, finish and eat dinner. Back to reading a chapter and write the summary. I don't want to get lost in the chapters. Perfect. Carla, finish editing and submit the story. Kelly, in the next sprint, I will finish this chapter, rewrite, and leave the protagonist beaten on the floor and maybe part of the next scene too. Ooh, nasty but nice. Inka, in the next sprint, I'm aiming to finish this chapter, then I have two more. Sweet. Elizabeth, I need to figure out how to write this mother getting brain surgery while she is in kidney failure from lupus nephritis. Two big things to manage. Is it her point of view or the daughter's? Because the daughter could just be dealing with the fears associated around that. Carla, right now I'm fighting with PWA about glue words. What is a glue word? I don't think I've ever heard that. Elizabeth, it's no wonder this woman is depressed and anxious. Yeah, I hear you on that. All right, guys, we're going to dive into our second 45. Deep breath. Let's pour ourselves onto the page one more time. We're just going to have a little 10 minute after that just to wind down, cool down, finish out our thoughts. So let's make this one count. 45 minutes. Let's dive into the page and pour that story out. Okay, guys, good luck, good writing. I'll see you on the other side of 45. How did you guys make out? I got one of the I got the prologue done. Calling the other one a flashback. So I'll try the flashback. Let's see. Seeing an amazing conversation about pro writing. Is that right? Which one did I say? What is it again? Yeah, pro writing aid. Saying it right. Questioning myself. let's see. I'm loving hearing how it picks up on the repetitive words, and not sure if that sounds like a helpful thing or not. I cannot pre-plan much of the book ahead of time. I have an idea of the beginning and usually have a good idea of the ending. I have to see where it goes. Yes. Mary Jo, thank you for subscribing. Very, very appreciated. Let's see. Trying to think where I left off here. I was kind of scanning it. let's see. What is that in relation? Has anyone read Jenna's craft book? Generosities. I read now. I'm about halfway through it and loving it. I think it's great. Inca, I draft in Scrivener, so I don't use PWA there because I'm in drafting mode. I just use it for edits in Word. I've only just started using Plotter. I'm not sure I'll stick with it. You have to see if it works for you, right? Heather, the next chapter didn't even have 400 words in it. I did what I could, but started on dinner while I brainstorm what I can add. Good plan. Let's see. What are you? NW 1039 that time and 2743 for our sprints. Nice. Tyler, I got 642 words that sprint. Mary Jo, no, I don't think I'm a discovery writer. I seem to write more stories that way, but they inevitably ended up in a corner. Lots of pretty words, but no direction. Interesting. Sam, 1,319 words that time. Devin, I was trying to do a word count check and delete a whole page of writing. Thank goodness for the how to do button. Yeah. Woo. Mary, dryer load, didn't finish drying, so running it again, swept the floors, but my back started hurting again, so took a break for the rest of the sprint. Oh, hon. Should alternate with some writing in there. Give yourself a reward for all this. Mary, let's see, I usually have an idea, dialogue, and a general path of where I'm going, but this one feels more complex and warrants an outline. Yes, the story dictates, right? I'm just getting bogged in the scenes plotting. Elaine, I got part of the NL draft done. NL. Okay. And I spent the rest of the sprint staring into space. I think I need a nap. We'll head out now. And thank you so much, Tracy, for the sprint. See you all tomorrow. Take it easy. Take the break. You probably need that mental break just to kind of refresh and renew. Mary, I started editing JM's book last night. Reading Jenna's book last night. Love it too. Sweet. Mary, also struggling with planning too much. My brain wants it to be perfect. Then it ends up not being as fun. That's a problem. Balance, half and half. Little plot, a little, write a little as you go, back and forth. Inca, I'm aiming to get to page 200 on this work in progress, and I'm 5 pages away, so I'll keep going. Nice. We have a 10-minute cooldown, guys. Rita, about half a chapter read and supper. Friendly reminder, save your work, folks. Oh, yeah. All right, guys. We are going to dive into our last 2-minute microsprint plan. This one is going to be for our cooldown. What do we need to hit to wrap everything up? Put it away in an organized way that we can jump in the next time we write and have your plan in place. Okay guys, so that can be what you need to reveal, what you're trying to get your protagonist to do on the page, obstacles and opportunities to either want to wrap up or are know what's coming next, action steps you're going to take to get there, resources, and outcome. Devin, good night everyone. Thanks for the sprint. You are so welcome, Devin. Thank you for joining us. Okay guys, in the next sprint I will, this one's going to be our last one for a 10. Let me go back up here and there. In the next sprint, I will. Inca, I've only pantsed 2 books in my life and I am not a pantser. They took forever to edit and I'm too lazy for that. I leer on that. Heather, in the next sprint, I will get dinner in the oven and continue brainstorm. I have to quit accidentally hitting the enter button. We all do that one. Carla, probably plan out when to do P&T tomorrow as I'm a little fried after submitting. Oh, yeah. Mary, thanks for hosting Tracy and thanks to for all the for the combo and company. I'm out. Thank you for joining us, Mary. Inca, in the next sprint, I will get through these 5 pages even if it makes my eyes dry out. You got this. You're so close. You got this. Sam, I'm going to continue writing on this chapter. Okay, guys, let's wrap this up. Let's do our 10-minute and just pour the remainder out of our heads. Get it on the page where we can come back to it tomorrow or the next day or whatever works for you, right? Okay, guys, 10-minute sprint. Deep breath. Let's get this, make this cool down matter. Let's get it on the page where we can do something about it. See you on this side of 10, guys. got to make out on that one. Oh, I was able to finish up the prologue, throw down a handful of questions to deepen where the story can go from there. Oh, it's so good. let's see. Inca, in the next sprint, I will get through these 5 pages. Oh, okay, I'm going to keep writing it. Okay, Carla, I love that the flash fiction daily prompts are really inspire me, but it's a lot of work. Oh, yeah. Concise and short is, that's a lot of work. but if they're fun and they're helping you with your writing craft, excellent choice. Mary, in the next sprint, I will continue resting and figure out what I want to tackle tonight versus what I'll save for tomorrow. Diane, thank you. You are so welcome. Tweeka, yes. Rita, I'm exhausted. I spent most of the time cleaning up my writing space. Time to rest and read a paperback. I'll be ready for tomorrow's writing time. Nice. Inca, got my 5 pages done. Okay, this is Ranka. Ah. You're awesome! Ah. Inca, you seriously rock. I hope you're doing a happy dance. Let's see. Mary decided I will put away clothes tonight and mop the kitchen. Vacuum can wait till tomorrow. Yeah. Sound 324 words for 2069 for the day so far. Nice. So thank you, Prosy. You are so welcome. Heather, dinner's in the oven. One idea to add to this, the chapter. Thank you for the sprints. You are so welcome. Hope to see you for planning tomorrow, but I will be at sprints for sure. I hope you can make it. I love you guys all being there. I find that we're growing so much together with our planning circle. Louise, I've made good progress. Now it's time for dinner and then the last sprint of the day. Thanks for hosting, Tracy. Always a pleasure to have 2 long sprints. So productive for me. I'm loving hearing that, guys. Inca, keep me posted on how you do with clutter. I am curious why you may not like it. Thank you. Definitely. Inca, thanks for hosting. You are so welcome. It was a very productive double down day for me. I was dancing along with puppers. okay, guys, I'm out of here. I will see you tomorrow at 3 p.m. for our planning session and 5 p.m. for our writing sprints. Just come and join me and we'll get ourselves organized, have ourselves a plan for the week ahead, and make sure we're getting done what matters, our writing. And good night, all. It's 1 a.m. for me and I'm beat. Well, thank you, guys. You are all so welcome and I'll see you tomorrow. Kick back, relax, have a bite. Refresh your beverage, read a good book, just get yourself sorted and organized, and tuck your writing away for a little bit. You've earned it. Have a little break. Okay, guys, I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.